Thank you guys for joining me for my baked mac and cheese recipe. The first thing you want to do is boil your elbow noodles in half water and half chicken stock just so they can get soft. Then you want to drain your noodles, but you do not want to rinse them off. Pre-spray your cooking or baking pan, and then once you do that, you want to pour over in your noodles and stir in one stick of salted butter. Then you want to add your Worcestershire sauce in to taste, like so. That's the type I use. Then you want to start your roux. You want to melt one stick of butter in a pan, a non-stick pan, okay? Then you want to add half a cup of flour to your melted butter, and you're going to stir that in. Now, you don't want any clumps and lumps, okay? You want to make sure that the flour is fully condensed in there. Once that happens, you want to add one cup of whole milk like this, okay? After you do that, you want to add in one cup of heavy cream, okay? It just gives that thickness that you're going to be looking for. Now, you want to start with your cheeses. I use sharp cheddar, mozzarella, white cheddar, and Colby Jack, but you can use whatever type of cheese you want to, okay? 8 ounces of all of those cheeses. And then you're going to put it directly into your roux, just like this, okay? Gonna just throw it over in your roux. All the cheeses. Now, baby, if you lactose intolerant, man, I don't know what to tell you. You know, I like my macaroni real cheesy. Now, it's going to start to thicken. Now, do not burn the roux, okay? Make sure you're constantly stirring it so it does not stick. After that, you want to add 2 tablespoons of cream cheese, like so. Now, don't go crazy with the cream cheese, okay? Just a little bit. Then you want to season to taste. Of course, you know paprika don't have a taste, baby, but you know we like to add it for the color. Okay, so you add your paprika. Then a little bit of black pepper in there, like so. Okay, after that, you want to add you some garlic powder in there. You know, just sprinkle it in there, baby. Don't ask me for the measurements for these because I don't know. Just to taste. That's all I can tell you. I like pink Himalayan salt. I'm going to add that in there. Now, once you've got all the seasons you want to add 2 tablespoons of sweetened condensed milk. Baby, it's going to give you that just pop in your mouth. You're just going to be like, oh, what's that little razzle dazzle? Don't overdo this, okay? Just 2 tablespoons will do you. Now, you got that creamy roux going, okay? Keep stirring, okay? You don't want it to stick. Now, if you want to add Velveeta to your noodles, that's fine. If you don't, that's fine too. I like to add it to mine. You want to stir directly onto your noodles 1 egg. Do not put your egg in the roux. You want to make sure that it sticks to your noodles, okay? Okay, you want it so that it's going to stick to your noodles. Put it on in there like that. I like to use my hands to rub it all in. You do what you desire. Now, you're going to add your roux in. Yes, it's supposed to be this thick, okay? Yes, it is. It just has to be. You know, you're going to work it in. Work it in with your noodles. Once you work it in, you're going to spread it across real good in your pan. See how pretty that look? See that? Yeah. Now you're going to add another 8 ounces of the sharp cheddar cheese just directly to the top of your macaroni. Just like that. Oh, you're looking cute and beautiful. Okay. You're going to put your macaroni in the oven on 350 degrees. Wham, bam. And you're going to let it bake for about 45 minutes. See, look at that. It's already getting done. Don't worry about them chops over there. See that little macaroni? Hey, oh my gosh. Now, baby, oh God, you see them crispy edges? Oh, it's got a little crunch. Oh, it's bubbling and baby, listen. Oh my goodness. This is what you want on your Sunday plate. You hear me? You, baby, it does not get any better than this right here. Okay? Go on and add that to your Sunday plate. You see those chops, that macaroni, and that little broccoli? Yes, ma'am. I hope y'all enjoyed this recipe. Let me know if you used it, okay? Y'all have a good and blessed day. Bye.